Is this a case of sour grapes?
Of course. Duh. Lambeer has a well-deserved reputation for being a bad guy around the NBA. A guy you'd want on your team. But certainly if you face him, you hate him. He was not only that kind of competitor, but that kind of mentality of never giving an inch, of bending and even breaking the rules if it meant he could get an advantage. And here, he's still salty about the fact that he thinks their dynasty was cut short by Jordan. When Jordan, first time Pippen hit his prime, they swept the Pistons like it was nothing. Even the previous year, the only reasons the Pistons won is because Pippen couldn't play in Game 7. And by the way, because Pippen really wasn't quite in his prime yet. It was his first year as an All-Star, but you look at all the numbers, he jumped up the following year, all the significant statistical numbers like PER, stuff like that. And before that, when the Pistons won, you got to be kidding. It's because Jordan had nothing around him. So Lambeer is lucky that they even won one. Because had Jordan been crewed up, the Pistons get not only exactly zero, they never get to a seventh game against the fully loaded Bulls squad. And he is salty about it.
I disagree. I don't think he's salty because I don't think he has a reason to be salty. Keep in mind that before the Jordan era began in terms of those championships in 1991, 88, 89, and 90, the Pistons beat the Chicago Bulls. They beat Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen and those boys. That last year, 1990, was when Pippen had the migraine headache. Prior to that, the Bad Boys were just no joke. They were an elite team. And in 1991, when Jordan finally beat them in the Eastern Conference Finals and they were on their way, the Pistons were clearly on the downside. Isaiah Thomas had aged in the first two games. Hold on, I'm not finished. In the first two games of the finals, if you remember, Isaiah Thomas had a combined 21 points, had 11 in game one, 10 points in game two. He wasn't himself. Joe Dumars showed up. But Lambeer and others, they just weren't the same anymore. They had been on a run. You have to remember, in the 80s, they were chasing the Boston Celtics, and the Boston Celtics had fended them off. One of my favorite moments that I ever watched was when they finally beat the Pistons, and they were going to the finals against the Lakers for the first time, and McHale had stood at midcourt and shook Isaiah Thomas's hand and was basically saying, all right, you got us finally. Now go get the chip. Go handle your business. It was a beautiful moment to see because it was a passing of the torch. The work that the Pistons had put in to go through Boston and then to beat Chicago and hold off Chicago.
That's the story.
By beating them 3 years in a row. Come on now. There's no sour grapes after that.
That's the story.
They dominated them.
I know that's the narrative that's been sold to NBA fans, and I'm actually a Pistons fan. I hated Larry Bird. I hated the Celtics. I loved Isaiah Thomas, and I rooted for those Pistons teams against everybody. I really loved those teams. But I'm here to tell you the narrative you've been sold is simply incorrect on the facts. The Pistons didn't get anything till Larry Bird's back went out. That's right. They didn't do anything against L.A. till really Kareem was done.
That is so ignorant.
They were
that
lucky
is so
that
ignorant.
At the end of the Lakers-Celtics dynasty, once that ended, they had a window before. Okay. But Jordan had zero All-Stars when the Pistons beat him. It was Michael Jordan and a cast of characters, none of whom were All-Stars. Then the Pistons could beat Jordan, and they had their hands full then.
That is not – you do it all the Jordan, time. The that is not the season, question. That's not the narrative. It's about sour grapes.
Well, the first season Jordan got an All-Star, they went seven games, and only because that All-Star wasn't available to him in Game 7 did the Pistons win, and then Jordan got crewed up and swept the Pistons, never to be heard from again. They were lucky. They existed. I hate to say this. I rooted for them. I love Isaiah and all those guys.
Right.
They were
lucky.
They existed at the end of Lakers-Celtics. Because Jordan ended them, he has sour grapes.
They felt like they were coming
Jordan
to an end
them.
Even before. They felt like they were coming to an end even before they met Jordan. And by the way, your notion that the media has been sold this. Well, I don't know if you remember this. Bill Lambeer used to work here. I know Bill Lambeer. I've spoken to him about this on many occasions.
Sure.
Obviously, I know Isaiah Thomas. I spoke to him about it. Joe Dumas. I know. I mean, this ain't no narrative that I read. I know the participants. I am telling you, their whole thing is they dominated Michael Jordan. They dominated the Bulls. They weren't worried about it. Your
Stephen
time
A.
comes and
Stephen
goes.
A, they dominated
That's what
him. They dominated him when they were a team full of excellent players and there was one great player on the Bulls and no other All-Stars. They dominated them.
Wait a minute.
As soon as
Pippen
Jordan
and Horace
got
Grant
a little bit of
guys,
help, the
did
Pistons
it compare?
Were done.
Did it compare? What with Bill Lambert, they were bad boys, they were physical, they beat you up, but it wasn't like it was a squad rife with all-stars. You had Isaiah Dumas and Dumas with the video of Microwave Johnson coming off the bench, but you didn't look at the Detroit Pistons as a bunch of all-stars. They were an elite team because they
at
were
the
physical.
Time, that was...
They beat you up and they played together. And they defended.
They were an extremely well-balanced team led by an MVP-caliber player in Isaiah.
They defended.
Multiple All-Stars on the team. And they were the greatest defensive team that I'd seen in my lifetime to that point. They were
Molly
tremendous.
And a producer. Call
and Jordan
Joe
got
Dumas.
Rid of them as
call
soon as he got a little bit of
Isaiah
help. He got
Thomas.
Rid of them.
I know these people. Call them up and ask them. Bitter. Bitter about what? They dominated. They dominated.
It's all about sour grapes.
They dominated.
They're bitter about anybody.
Guys,
they're bitter
heard
about
of them
Boston
if Jordan had a crew
LA
back then.
Taking
it's
some
been
of
a
their
lot
shine.
Of fun.